we're heading out here to historic Bucks County, Pennsylvania. The last 3 years, look forward to this hunt. Not necessarily the biggest deer in the country. This is a place where the deer herd definitely needs thinned, and we are happy to oblige with the Camex and Elite. All right, we just made it in the new town. It's time to unload the truck. Get ready to go.
So we're in such a big rush to get in the woods and we're behind the eight ball for time. We throw our clothes on and we're straight to the tree. That's the only thing that mattered.
All right, it's my first sit of 2018. We are in Bucks County, Pennsylvania. The weather has been crazy from this hurricane. The creeks are absolutely just busting at the seams. These deer should be bedded below us. We're hoping they'll still cross the creek to come up and eat in this bean field. Our wind's blowing from the creek to the beans, so our hope and plan is that we can kill them before they get to the beans. So this place is absolutely covered up with deer, so I believe it's just a matter of time before we see the right buck and have an opportunity to seal the deal with the Elite.
So the anticipation, once I sit in the tree, I pull the Elite up and I got everything set up, I can't help but think about last year. I think about the opportunities that I didn't have. Last year was the absolute worst hunting year of my life when it came to big whitetail bucks. And man, I carried that all the way through. I always have this fear of failing. Man, am I a failure? Is this what we're supposed to be doing? God, is this where you want me to be? And just really struggle with that. And here we are, we're at it. And I'm just wondering, God, what are the plans that you have for me?
It might be a lucky pair of socks or routine before or after a hunt. Whatever it may be, trust that hunt to the most shootable and efficient bow ever developed. Honor the ritual.
Our walk defines who we are. At work, at home, and in the field. And just like our walk, a company is defined by its walk. A walk that is made by its people and its products. All of our targets are made in the USA with 100% recycled materials, designed to withstand thousands of shots with one of the easiest arrow removals in the industry. The only thing that surpasses the quality of our targets is the quality of the relationships we build with our customers. When you purchase one of our targets, you become part of a family. Welcome to the Walk-On Archery family.
Last year was the absolute worst hunting year of my life. Let me tell you how great the year was and how many deer we killed. Nothing. So being a performance-driven individual, you know, and owning I Supply and the things that I'm involved in and with the ministry I created and feeling the need to feel successful, like we all have that. And man, I didn't get that out of season two. So I carried that around all spring and summer, and here we are fall, and my heart is like, God, what are you going to do this year? And I know that God taught me a lesson, because I remember praying at the end of the last day of Ohio, saying, God, man, this season has been a horrible season for whitetail. And when I hear the voice of God say, Doug, if you base the season of your life off of whitetail harvest, you have failed as a man. It humbled me. It took me back to my roots. I'm thankful for that. And I'm thankful for the next season. See the first legs coming in a distance through the trees, and don't know really what it is. So I grabbed the dual grunt call and gave her just a real soft grunt to let whatever deer know that there's another buck in that area, and the gates open up and here they come. Animal, and you know, early season whitetails, they love to hang out in their bachelor groups, right? So who knows what's gonna show up? Well, here comes another buck and another buck, and we're watching them cross the creek. They're coming right to where these acorns are dropping, and we know that the distance is getting smaller and smaller, and that moment of truth, it's about to happen.
Established in a small town in 1981. A company that produces quality products that archers have come to rely on. I started shooting with a Scott release and have passed the tradition on. My dad always told me, never forget where you came from. Well, I haven't. Shoot with confidence. Shoot a Scott.
Let's be honest, we all need a dependable truck. And when you buy a car, you want to feel like you bought it off somebody that you can trust. And I've always felt that way, honestly, with all of my heart, coming here to Vanderveer Chevrolet.
Our trucks come with a warranty forever, car washes for life. So when you're out there in the mud and you get a little dirty, you can bring it on down, drive it through the car wash.
Leaving with a smile on your face, knowing you got that good deal, and knowing that if something happens, do you have that peace of mind with that lifetime warranty? With what I do and who I am, my integrity, I want it to be respected at the highest level. And I know with the customers that I send here, they all call me and say, you sent us to the right place. And that's what Vanderveer Chevrolet is for us. This is the right place.
Hey, we'll be glad to help you out and treat you the same as we do Doug. We want to do the same for you.
Getting ready at any moment to have an opportunity to try to pull off this shot. Well, I'd be a liar if I didn't tell you all the things the devil tried to put back in my head about what happened last year. And I had to quickly gather myself and focus on, it's not about last year, it's about right here and right now and the opportunity that's out in front of me. And I just remember saying, Lord, if this is what you want to happen, then let it be. And here comes the adrenaline rush, baby. It's on like Donkey Kong. I'm all kinds of jacked up. God delivered, 4 hours in, blown away. I'm about ready to fall out of the tree. I'm an emotional disaster.
I can't believe it. First night in the stand, we smoke an awesome 8-pointer here in Pennsylvania. He's laying over there. He's down. Oh my gosh. Smackdown. Oh my goodness.
You've never watched an episode of Created Outdoors, man. My best friend in the whole wide world is my wife. You know, my wife and I have been through a lot of good things. We've been through a lot of tough things. And to call her to celebrate that God-given, created moment for me is part of my ritual.
I just smoked one.
Yes.
40 yards. I smoked him at 40 yards. He's laying down. He's the biggest one. There was like five came in on us, and he's wide. He's a really good buck, Pennsylvania buck. Love you, boy. We made the right choice to come here. He's not an Ohio pooner, but he's a good buck.
All right, so we're down out of the tree. We're letting the deer lie. And, Mark shows up. And for Mark to open his beautiful property in Pennsylvania, to us, he got to celebrate that with us. He was more excited probably than I was, figuratively speaking, to grab a hold of a brother and give him a big hug and share that fellowship, that moment, that embracing of, man, we have accomplished something super special today. What an awesome opportunity.
Came from my right. He walked right down the little creek. Came out, meandered around. There's probably 4 or 5 other bucks with him.
That's what I was gonna say, around the edge of this corner right here. There's something staring at me. I don't know if you had your blocks on it, but we'll buck him out.
We shoot down over the hill. We know where this deer fell over at.
With a whole lot of blood on it. We don't have to follow this blood trail. Look at that thing.
So it's every hunter's favorite time to flip them over and gut them out, right? It's a celebratory time when you get to get the hands and the elbows bloody deep because you're successful. So I get in there, I'm pulling the goodies out and pull the heart out. But at 40 yards, that slick trick made a perfect 10 ring bullseye heart shot. What an awesome testimony. Like a flood, everything that I carried last year suddenly just disappeared. Those learning moments that I had, that feel of defeat, certainly at that point turned to victory. I had to think about, man, it's hard to learn things during good seasons. Like, we can close our eyes, we can close our ears, and we can just know that we're succeeding, we're being successful. But when you look back at the tough seasons, when you feel defeated and the trials against you and you're walking through that fire, it all comes back around to making that full circle to know it's God's way of shaping us and making us and molding us and teaching us to not forget where you came from, not forget the trial. God showed me that through last season and this season. And if I wouldn't have went through that trial, I know I wouldn't have learned what I learned. And I think it's so important as men and women, as how we influence each other and how we educate our children. These are the opportunities and the times that we have to take the garbage and the trash that we had, that junk, that dirt, and use the gospel and our relationship with Jesus as He pours into our life and nurtures us and grows us in the direction that glorifies Him. Tune in for episode 2. And it suddenly strikes me, I'm gonna jump behind the camera. I take Matt, we buy his hunting license. Dude's got 4 days to get it done. We're about to have a really good time.
I try and I try, but I'm always falling. Enough is enough, it's time to give up. I lay it all down, Jesus, I surrender. Your presence, your spirit is breathing new life into my soul. I'm only free, only alive with my clenched fists. Let go, take my life, take control until my feet are walking on.
There's Ben setting up the gear, getting the party started.